Today, I'm going to review something that is not directly related to game consoles, but some of you might love it. Want to know what it is? Let's get started. This video is supported by PlayLab. To be honest, I never read or heard this company before, but if you open their website, they are selling anything related to video games, so it's worth a try. When I first got the package, I knew this is a mechanical keyboard, but I don't know the details, the colors, the specs, etc. So let's find it out in a moment. It says DK61 Bluetooth Mechanical Keyboard. Is DK61 a brand name? I don't know, but it means a computer keyboard with 61 keys in total. So it is not a full-size keyboard. And as usual, colors mean fun. So this is a mechanical gaming keyboard. And the keyboard color is white. Let's open the package and see what it looks like. First impression, clean and neat. And the keyboard itself is hefty. It is not light at all, so I think it should be excellent in terms of weight. This is the instruction manual. The keycap puller. And the USB cable. By the way, you can use this keyboard wirelessly or wired. Let's take a look at the keyboard itself. I feel that the keyboard is compact and solid and looks very professional. You can see the USB Type-C port on the back of the keyboard, and on the back side, you can find the power button. And as I said previously, this keyboard has no brand name and no official website either, as it is not printed on the back sticker. Maybe we can call it a generic mechanical gaming keyboard. Now let's try pulling one of the keycaps and find the brand of the key switch. We cannot see the brand of the key switch clearly, but when I look closely, it is the Altimo Red. When I searched the internet about Altimo, I found that this is one of the Cherry MX clones made in China. Altimo is often considered as the most budget-friendly of the clone switches, but many people enjoy it. Altimo switches also struggle with the lack of durability as they cannot withstand 100 million keystrokes unlike the Cherry MX. In general, Altimo switches are an excellent switch for the price, but they come with some trade-offs. Since this keyboard uses the Altimo Red, then the switch is on the same level as the Cherry MX Red in terms of speed and accuracy. Now we will take a look on the keycap. The manufacturer said that the keycap's material is PBT, and it is a double-shot keycap, so the color won't wear out over time. Now I will reinstall the keycap. And here's how the keyboard sounds when we are typing. The instruction manual comes in several languages, and it is easy to understand. Since this is a 61-key gaming keyboard, so you might need to often use the FN or function key in conjunction with other keys to get the desired result. I will show you how to utilize some of the FN functions later. Now let's try to turn on the keyboard. This keyboard has something like a boot animation, so let's see it together. I think it is cool. Do you guys agree with me? To perceive the keyboard lighting effects better, I will turn off all the lights in my room. Abracadabra. Awesome. Now I will show you the boot animation in case you didn't see it clearly. Sensational, isn't it? And it doesn't stop here. This keyboard has several pre-built lighting effects to use. Press the FN button and the tab button to cycle through it. And we are back to square one. So there are a total of 18 lighting effects to use. And if you choose to activate one color only for each theme, then maybe you can do the math. We can also make or customize the lighting effect by pressing the FN and the Z key together. Pressing those combination keys for the first time will show you the pre-made theme. Now press and hold the FN and the Z key for 3 seconds to set it up. While those keys are blinking, press any keyboard keys that you want to light it up. Pressing once on any keyboard key will turn that key to red. Pressing the same keyboard key twice will turn the key to orange, and so on. To end the customization, press and hold the FN and the Z key together. If you press the FN and the tab key, it will switch to the standard theme. While pressing the FN and the Z key will show you the customized theme. So I think this keyboard has an unlimited theming capability. Well, if we count the custom theme. As I said previously, you can use this keyboard wirelessly and wired. And this keyboard is compatible with the Windows PC, Apple Macintosh, iOS, and Android devices. This section will show you how to connect this keyboard to the Windows PC using a USB cable and using a Bluetooth connection. Before connecting this keyboard to a computer using a USB cable, we need to make sure that this keyboard is powered off, or else you cannot use it. Get a USB Type-C cable and plug it to the keyboard's USB port. Open an app like a notepad and start typing. Now let's try using the Bluetooth connection. To start using a Bluetooth connection, we need to power on the keyboard. This keyboard has three Bluetooth connection profiles, so we can connect this keyboard to three devices without the need to reset the Bluetooth connection each time you want to use it. Let me show you how it is. For the first profile, let's try connecting the keyboard to a Windows PC. Press and hold the Fn button and the left shift button for 5 seconds. You can see that both buttons are now blinking and waiting for the Bluetooth connection. Open the Bluetooth settings on the Windows PC. Then click Add Bluetooth or Other Device. Select Bluetooth. And choose the DK61 USB Bluetooth 5.0 keyboard. And you are ready to use the keyboard. For the second profile, let's try to connect the keyboard to an Android device. Press and hold the Fn and the left control key for 5 seconds. Open the Bluetooth settings on the Android device, search for the keyboard name, and pair it. Now let's try to open the note and begin typing. If you want to continue typing on the Windows PC, just press the Fn button and the left shift. If you want to add the final Bluetooth profile, press the Fn and the left Alt key for 5 seconds. When used in wireless mode, this keyboard lasts for about 10 hours. Let me show you how to charge it. Plug in any USB charger and let it sit for some time. The indicator will turn red while it charges. And when the keyboard is fully charged, the indicator will turn green. So I guess the product review video has come to an end. I think this keyboard is reliable and has potentials, although it has no brand name. Would I recommend it? Yes, if you want a budget-friendly mechanical gaming keyboard with beautiful lighting effects. Thanks for watching this video. See you guys later. Cheers!